will help you give you the shape that you need. But you need to spend some money on that. So, but if it is for the purpose of, if I have a child, oh, will he be able to suck? Yes, the child can suck. In your antenatal, when you booked your pregnancy, they will teach you further what you need to do about that breast. Time is never our friend. Would have loved to take more questions, but because of time, we will stop here and we'll continue with our next episode. But meanwhile, remain healthy, because it's our concern in this program that you are healthy.
Mental health. It is the level of psychological well-being or absence of mental illness. It determines how one handles stress, relates with others, and makes choices. In the course of life, if one experiences mental health problems, one's thoughts, mood, and behavior could be affected. This illness is very common, but the affected can get better and recover completely. The World Mental Health this year was targeted at suicide prevention, in which suicide has been a global public health problem. The awareness was aimed at reducing the stigma associated with suicide and to inform people struggling with it that they are not alone. According to World Health Organization, suicide is the second leading cause of death among 15 to 29 years of age, and close to 800,000 people die due to suicide every year, which is one person every 40 seconds. This death is a tragedy for family, friends, and colleagues, which may have long-lasting effects. Most common methods of suicide are hanging, pesticide self-poisoning, and firearms. Fortunately, suicides can be prevented by early identification, management, and follow-up of people at risk, restricting access to its means, educating media on non-sensational suicide reports, and implementing programs among young people to build life skills.
Show today on Mother Care, so much information. You know, the show Bipolar is amazing, because sometimes we don't like to admit what is right in front of us. Sometimes you know someone like that, but you know, it's just something we don't like to talk about. But knowledge is key. It can be managed. And for all of you there who want to get married, and your people will go to the village to find out if there's a madness in the family. Honestly, let somebody do that to my child, then you know. But that's aside, because some people were going to my village, but I'm not going to say anything. But it is a stigma that we should get rid of, so people can actually get the help and the care they need, and they do not hide. That's it on Mother Care today. I do hope you had a lot of information, education, and all the knowledge you can actually acquire. Remember, all our links are there for you, so get in touch with us if you have more questions or you need clarification on anything we've discussed on the show today. We are always, always willing to help. My name is Marian, and to every mom out there, being a mom, best job in the world. Thanks for watching.
Information is power. Everyone wants power. So feel powerful with the NTA News mobile app, the one-stop information center. Real news at your fingertip. Be the first to report by uploading first-hand information on the You Report link. And be the first to know by simply clicking on any of the links on the sidebar for headlines, domestic and foreign news, economy, security, politics, sports, and more. Stream live on your smartphone and tablets and stay connected. It's pretty easy. Simply download NTA News app from your Google Play Store and you're good to go. NTA News mobile app, your access to real-time information.
Welcome to Nigeria, a fascinating country. Take a trip through one of the most beautiful places on earth. A journey of discovery. A unique opportunity to get in touch with unspoiled nature. Enjoy your time in a place that offers something for everyone. A land of beautiful contrasts. An experience you won't forget.
Welcome to the news on NTA International. I'm Musbah and Wahab. Let's see the headlines. International Day for Disaster Risk Reduction. Experts say everyone should understand the concept. Endorsement of Nigeria's foreign direct investment destination in Africa, enabled by favorable investments and relatively secured environment. One all draw at international friendly encounter between Nigeria's Cruzeiro and Celasa of Brazil. Thanks a lot for staying tuned in. Let's let you know that First Lady of Nigeria, Aisha Muhammad Buhari, has returned to the country after a long rest under the instruction of her doctors. Aisha Buhari, who returned Sunday morning, expressed optimism that she is back, fully rejuvenated to continue her work of improving the health and general well-being of women, children and other less privileged Nigerians. She was received by wife of Kogi State Governor Rashida Bello, Dr. Mario Almakura, and the Senior Special Assistant to the President, Dr. Haju Sani, among other dignitaries. While expressing gratitude to Nigerians for their support, the First Lady assured them of commitment to uplift their living standards through the Future Assured Program and the Aisha Buhari Foundation. Buhari media organization said the rating of Nigeria as the third largest recipient of foreign direct investments in Africa testifies to the focused posture by the current administration. In a statement jointly signed by the chairman, Niyi Akinshiju, and Secretary Cassidy Madueke, it says the rating by ERNSC and Young justifies the assurances by President Muhammadu Buhari on delivering his electoral promises. The group enjoins Nigerians to sustain faith with the president and the federal government as it marches on rebuilding the country. It says the large inflow of foreign direct investment into the country is a direct positive outcome of the federal government's policy of ease of doing business, favorable investment climates and relatively security prevalent in the country. BMO noted that the deliberate efforts of the current administration to curb corruption in the system and removing obstacles for foreign investments enabled an inflow of about $8 billion in 2018, at least 65% projects, leading to the creation of about 10,000 direct and indirect jobs in the country. It alludes that it is a demonstration of a wavering faith of international investors in Nigeria's economy under the current dispensation. The group says it is obvious that based on these developments, President Buhari is right in his position that Nigeria is open and ready for the world to come and invest. BMO also harps on the fact that under President Muhammadu Buhari, Nigeria has remained on a sustainable economic growth, especially as economy is one of the three major planks of his government alongside security and the fight against corruption. President Muhammadu Buhari has taxed graduates of Navy Direct Service Course 26, Regular Course 66 cadets among other trainees commissioned as sub-lieutenants to bring discipline and expertise gained to bear in the service of their fatherland. The President, represented by the Chief of Defense Staff, General Abayomi Olonisaki, speaking of a passing out parade at Navy Training School on River State. Kinsley Amajiri reports.
...113 midshipmen of Regular Course 66, 73 cadets of Direct Short Service Course 26, and 14 cadets of Special Duties Course 2019 in the last 6 to 8 months undertook training in the areas of leadership and management, security and logistics administration, weapon handling, sea navigation, among others, to prepare them for higher national service. Coming at a time that the nation is going through some security challenges, especially with the incidents of maritime security threats. The president wants the new officers to justify the nation's investment in their training, calling on them to remain professional, selfless, and make sacrifices towards national security.
The president, commander-in-chief of the armed forces of Nigeria, expects you to be loyal to the constituted authority and be prepared to give necessary support to the Nigerian police and other paramilitary agencies in the discharge of their duties. A lot will be expected of you as newly commissioned officers, especially in the light of the contemporary security challenges our nation faces.
As you depart the coach, I want you to know that the beautiful parade you just now left and the suit you revealed glistening ground on your shoulders are reminiscent of the fact that the rainbow appears after the storm.
12 of the 200 commissioned officers made first class. This is as some of them say they are poised to serve their fatherland. The high point of the event was the unveiling of their new rank and the administration of the oath of allegiance from One, River State, Kingsley Amajiri, NTA News.
Today is the International Day for Disaster Risk Reduction, instituted in 1989 by the United Nations General Assembly to promote a global culture of risk awareness and disaster reduction. This year's theme is reduce disaster damage to critical infrastructure and disruption of basic services. The day celebrates how people and communities in the world are reducing exposure to disasters and raising awareness about the importance of curbing the risk they face. This year's focus is on the Sendai Framework D, which is to substantially reduce disaster damage to critical infrastructure and disruption of basic services, among them health and education facilities, including through developing resilience by 2030. Given the high death tolls, notably in earthquakes and means it is especially important that great care is taken to ensure that schools and hospitals are built to last by ensuring that location and other appropriate planning regulations and building codes are enforced. Other areas of critical infrastructure which helps to achieve other Sendai Framework targets, including potentially life-saving utilities and services such as food and water supply, energy, telecommunications and transport. Last year's target focused on prevention, protection and reducing the number of people affected by disasters. Now, it has become pertinent for every citizen and government to take part in building more disaster resilient communities. This, experts say, can be achieved if everyone is made to understand the concept of disaster risk reduction and benefits. Ifeoma Ahoja's report is in relation with the United Nations declarations of October 13 as World Disaster Risk Reduction Day.
The United Nations General Assembly since 1989 designated October 13 as Disaster Risk Reduction Day. The annual observance is a vehicle to promote a global culture of natural disaster reduction through prevention, mitigation, and preparedness. According to United Nations data, between 1998 and 2017, natural disasters killed about 1.3 million people, left 4.4 million displaced, and caused economic losses of around $2.9 trillion worldwide. Considering these alarming statistics, the theme for 2019 observance is reducing disaster damage to critical infrastructure and limiting the disruption of basic services and potential life-saving utilities.
Natural hazards do not necessarily mean natural disasters. Now, when it becomes disaster, there must be some loss of lives.
To checkmate these actions, they propose increased citizen education on the issue of disaster reduction and political will and resources to reinforce the achievement of humanity.
This indiscriminate bush burning should be curtailed. Nobody has the right to go and set fire in any bush, especially this Harmattan that is coming very soon. If you do that at a very small portion, before you know it, it can consume a whole community.
Let people know that when you sweep refuse and block the drains, you are contributing to something building up. Because it simply means that where water will come and they don't have a free flow.
As the global community marks the 2019 Day for Disaster Risk Reduction, it is important to evaluate disasters that have rocked society and seek ways of mitigating or preventing future occurrences. In Uyo, Ifeoma Aguji, NTN News.
To other matters now, though there have been improvements in Nigeria's judiciary, more still needs to be done, according to the Senate Committee on Judiciary, Human Rights and Legal Matters, to ensure sanity and application of modern court processes that meet best practices. The committee met with the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Ibrahim Tanko, President of the Nigerian Court of Appeal, Zainab Bukachua. National Assembly Correspondent Abdullahi Aminu reports.
This is a maiden oversight by the committee to keep abreast with the progress made by both two upper courts in the last couple of years and deliberate on their challenges for appropriate legislative interventions. Chief Justice of Nigeria, Justice Ibrahim Tanko, seeks for increase in budgetary allocation to judicial sector, while the nation's Court of Appeal is expecting quite a number of election cases after the completion of tribunal's assignments.
We ensure that court which is making a request for the employment has all the facilities.
We've been trying with the challenges, we've been trying with the workload, and we've been doing our best to ensure that we do what is expected of us.
This, no doubt, would enable us to make appropriate legislative interventions in times ahead for the betterment of the judiciary.
The committee gave its commitment to ensuring transparent justice delivery system in the country. From the National Assembly, Abdullahi Aminu, NTA News.
The federal government has restated commitment to ensure adequate protection of lives and property of Nigerians, especially those living within and around border towns. The Minister of Interior, Ogbeni Rauf Aregbesola, who gave the assurance while commissioning an operation base for men and officers of Nigerian Immigration Service, Osun State Command at Ojaode in Yewa North local government area of the state, said security remains topmost priority of the federal government. Hakim Jimo reports.
The partial closure of Nigeria's borders with neighboring countries by the federal government is a deliberate attempt to curtail illegal activities such as smuggling and transborder crime in beefing up security architecture through the provision of modern-day security gadgets and equipment. Minister of Interior Ogbeni Rauf Aregbesola and Ogun State Governor Prince Dapo Abiodun agreed that the closure is already yielding positive results.
Revenue from duties alone, custom duties alone, was almost quadrupled what we had ever had. Why? Because with the deal that is now enforced or taking place at the border post, goods do not enter our country without effective payment of the right duty.
We expect our law enforcement agencies to carry out their duties as enshrined in the Constitution. We must also join hands with them and encourage them to do so without allowing them to become excessive.
For the Controller General of Immigration, Mohammed Babandide, and others, the commissioning of the State of the Art facility will help motivate officers to do more.
Trade of legal items. You cannot trade on arms. You cannot trade on the rights we don't want. You cannot trade on drugs that will kill our people.
Awards of excellence exchanged hands at the venue, even as the dignitaries thereafter embarked on facility tour of the operations base.
Thanks a lot for that report. Now you're watching the news on NTA International. We'll take a short break. We have more reports. Stay with us.
Hey, you! And I got to talk to Sabina. It's wetin dey your mind, Abi? The person wey dem go help us. Baba Toro, San Shangalo, Oga Lekova, Mr. Sabi. You know if he carry last for this one.
A spear into the top corner.
We Sabi say pikin crawl before him waka. So don't look, no help anybody. No totally no. So go for him. Go for football. Go for all Syria on the Liga Marches live. Go for Go TV Max.
NTA International News. Africa as it is.
Thanks a lot for staying tuned in to the news. Now, activities marking the 40th anniversary celebration of the Nigerian Television Authority, NTA, Abeokuta, have commenced the awareness work across major streets of the capital. Mohammed Adebowale reports that the work tagged Work Against Fake News was led by the general manager of the station, Fumi Wakama.
Started from the old governor's office at Okelewo and terminated at Ogbe, the host community of the station. Apart from discouraging fake news and hate speech, the work was to show appreciation to its numerous viewers while also sensitizing citizens of the state on NTA's journey for 40 years.
We are clearly the news leader, and that's why we take our time before we go out there to break any news. We confirm it, we ensure that it is true, we make sure that it is authentic.
Hate speech, fake news, they all bring about insecurity in our society. That is why we are joining NTA to celebrate and work against these two monsters.
People say the contributions of NTA Abeokuta to its host community is enormous.
You are the first one in Abeokuta. I like your service. I want you to put more for effort in order to let your work be seen in everywhere in Abeokuta.
The anniversary lecture titled Lens and Sound, Television as a Tool for Social Reorientation and Good Governance will climax the event on Thursday, 17th of October in Abeokuta. Mohammed Adebowale, NTA News.
A celebration of 40 years of service. Now, when you are consumed with a passion of impacting positively on the society, especially with regards to putting smiles on the faces of the less privileged, you can go miles to ensure that your dreams come true. This informs the launching of the Family Circle and Upliftment Foundation, a pet project of the wife of Ebonyi State Governor, which has been at the forefront of lifting burdens off the shoulders of the downtrodden in Abakaliki, the state capital. Kingsley Okoro reports.
Registered in 2015 to touch lives, fight female genital mutilation, and end all forms of violence against women in the state, the Family Support and Upliftment Foundation has been constantly used for the people's welfare. The relaunch provided opportunity to extend the success it recorded since its inception by the wife of the state governor, Mrs. Rachel Omahi.
To the glory of God, Family Support and Upliftment Foundation has provided a fountain of hope to underprivileged families, especially women, the aged and children.
Governor David Omahi appreciated the development partners for their assistance, stressing that the best sacrifice anyone can give is to assist the downtrodden.
The Amortis Foundation, the UNICEF, the USAID, the UNDP, and then, of course, some of you too. So I want to commend them very well.
There were good messages from the development partners.
We continue to support you both financially, spiritually, and otherwise.
Aside development partners, the event attracted political class and other critical stakeholders, including the wife of Enugu State Governor, Mrs. Monica Ugwanyi. In Abakaliki, Kingsley Okoro, NTA News.
Ministry of Foreign Affairs has refuted a video which has gone viral on the social media showing an attack on the embassy of Nigeria in Cotonou, Benin Republic. A statement by the spokesperson of the ministry, Ferdinand Nwoye, says the video is an old video of an attack on the Nigerian embassy in Dakar, Senegal, which occurred 6 years ago, precisely on the 4th of March 2013, and perpetrators punished by Senegalese government. The statement further calls on the public to disregard the information being spread by mischief makers to whip up sentiments and cause unnecessary tension in Nigeria and Benin relations. It reiterates that the embassy of Nigeria in Cotonou was never attacked and is not under any form of attack. It says the embassy's premises and its personnel are safe, well protected, and free from any form of threat or danger. Now, we now join Joyce Ometu with our World in 6 Days segment of the news.
Glad to have you join us on the World in 6 Days. The 2019 Nobel Peace Prize was awarded during the week to Ethiopian Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed. Recognized for his efforts at ending 20 years' war between Ethiopia and Eritrea, as well as achievement of peace and international cooperation, particularly for his decisive initiative to resolve the border conflict with neighboring Eritrea. In South Africa, hundreds of refugees were said to be camping outside the office of the United Nations Refugee Agency in Cape Town, seeking protection as they no longer feel safe in that country. Reports revealed that they are from Rwanda, Burundi, Democratic Republic of Congo, and Bangladesh. Blamed high levels of crime as well as xenophobia for their predicament. Now elsewhere, a cargo plane carrying presidential officials crashed in eastern Congo Thursday. All 8 passengers and crew died. Congo Civilian Aviation Authority said the plane carrying the driver of President Felix Tshisekedi, a logistic manager, and some soldiers took off from Goma to the capital, Kinshasa. They went off radar an hour after departing. Russian Embassy in Democratic Republic of Congo confirms that the Russians were among the crew members on board. Still in the week under review, 7 people were reported dead and hundreds displaced after heavy rains pounded the northeastern town of Korogwe, Tanzania. Reports indicate that a teacher's cottage and a market were damaged. Authorities managed to evacuate those affected to safe areas, while drivers were warned not to use affected roads since the bridges and the road surfaces may be precarious. Now, the White House said during the week that it will not cooperate with impeachment inquiry into President Donald Trump. A letter sent to the Democratic leadership described the inquiry as baseless and constitutionally invalid. 3 Democratic-led House committees are investigating President Trump. The inquiry is investigating if the president held back aid to Ukraine to push it to investigate Joe Biden, who is running for Democratic presidential nomination. Now, Turkish forces stepped up airstrikes and ground offensive as their incursion into Kurdish-held areas of northern Syria continued. Turkey's military said it seized designated targets. However, there were reports of heavy fighting in the central border region and 7 civilian deaths recorded. Tens of thousands of people were reported to have left their homes. The assault on Kurdish-led forces, key U.S. allies, follows U.S. President Donald Trump's decision to withdraw U.S. troops. And these are some of the stories that made rounds on the foreign scene during the outgoing week. Many thanks for staying. I'm Joyce Ometu.
Thanks a lot to you too, Joyce. And now in sports, Super Eagles and Seleção share the spoils in Singapore, as Manzi Marcus reports on sports.
Nigeria Super Eagles and Leca of Brazil on Sunday ended their international friendly on a 1-0 draw at the National Stadium in Singapore. Joe Aribo opened with a goal in the 35th minute, while Casemiro, another midfielder, levels scores in the 48th minute.
All in all to Moses Simon, considering he was the only player he could hit inside the penalty box. They've just walked all the way through, and it is a goal once again for Joe Aribo, his second international. short, hoping for the ball to come right back at him. It does go down to the crossbar, and surely it'll be the equalizer. Flag stays down. Brazil are right back in it. It's Casemiro.
Excellent play, Brazil, to just turn it around a little bit. They know that.
Nigeria's goalkeeper Francis Uzoho suffered an injury and was substituted by debutant Maduka Okoye as Brazil again ended their second international friendly within a week in a draw. In tennis, Daniil Medvedev on Sunday won the Shanghai Masters, beating Alexander Zverev in straight sets of 6-4, 6-1 in 73 minutes. The Russian does earn his first victory over the German after four unsuccessful attempts, and the Shanghai title is the fourth for the 23-year-old Medvedev. In a related development, Rebecca Peterson is winner of the Tianjin Open. The Swedish 24-year-old world number 59 claimed the title after a 6-4, 6-4 triumph over British number 2 Heather Watson. With sports update, Amanzi Marcus, NTA News.
And up next is the weather prospect for Nigeria and some cities of the world. And that concludes the news on. Thanks a lot for your time. Join us again.